Okay, so now you can see here. Yes. Okay, so this thing here, this is very important. That is only 85% of pre-stress you have to consider, because as I told you, you can see here it is given in the statement. See, loss of 15%. The loss of 15% is given here. Okay, so that is the reason you have to consider only 85% is the effective stress. Then after that, I told you this, that is 15 MPa. Okay, so for top fiber stress, that should be equated to 15 MPa, and for bottom fiber, that should be equated to 1 MPa. Okay, so yes, this term is important now. Okay, so P by A plus MD by Z plus ML by Z minus PE by Z, that should be equated to 15 Newton. Okay, Newton per mm square. Then from this, you have to find out the lie load required. That is, we got the lie load as 14. Okay, the lie load required as 41.5 kilonewton per meter. 41.5 kilonewton per meter. Okay, you can see here. You got it is 41.5 kilonewton per meter. So because they asked to calculate the load, so I'll come back here once again. Yes. Calculate the maximum UDL that it can carry if the maximum compression is 15 and the tensile as 1 MPa. Okay. So this, by considering these two, we have to find out the UDL, maximum UDL it can carry. So by considering the 15, we got 41.5 kilonewton per meter. Again, by considering stress at bottom fiber, P by A minus MD by Z minus ML by Z plus P by Z equal to tension, that is minus 1 MPa. You have to equate it to minus 1 MPa. Okay. Then again, from this, we got the load as 19 kilonewton per meter. But which load we have to consider, that is important here. Which load we have to consider. So I have given from 1 and 2, we can say that the maximum value of UDL allowed is 19 kilonewton per meter, so that it does not exceed the tensile and compressive stress limits. So we have got two values of load. So we have to use the minimum of those two. Okay. As I told you, we have got two values, that is first value with respect to the stress 15 Newton per mm square, we got the WL as 41.5 kilonewton per meter, and by considering stress is equal to minus 1 MPa, we got the load was 19 kilonewton per meter. So by considering compressive stress as well as tensile stress, we got two values of load, but we have to consider the least of those two, because what will happen at 19, when the 19 load applied, the allowable stress is minus 1. So even if you apply load beyond 19, what will happen? Do not take the tensile stress, so the section will fail. Okay, so out of that, 1 and 2, we have to consider least of 1 and 2. Okay, so we got 19 kilonewton per meter. So from 1 and 2, we can say that the maximum value of UDL allowed is 19 kilonewton per meter, so that it does not exceed the tensile and compressive stress limit. So please, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Yes, anyone? Aziz?
Yes, sir.
Samajh mein aa raha hai?
Yes, sir.
कुछ डाउट है तो पूछो अभी.
नो डाउट सर.
ओके. हरियंत? हरियंत?
नो सर.
ಇರ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾ ಸರ್.
ಏನ್ ಹಂಗ ಹೇಳತ್ರಿ?
ಒಂದ್ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಆಗೋ ಬ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಆಗತ್ತೈತ್ರಿ, ಈ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ತಿಳಿಲಿಲ್ಲ.
ಈಗ ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್, ಅದು ಬ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಆಗಿದಲ್ಲ, ಅದ ನಾ ಈಗ ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ ಅದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ PDF ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್. ಈಗ ಬ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಹೋಗೋದು ಬಂದ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ನೋಡಿ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಆಗಡೆ ಬ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಆಗೈತ. ನಂದ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಐತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ನಂದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಲ್ಯಾಪ್ಟಾಪ್ ಸೈಮಲ್ಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡತ್ತೇನ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಯು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಬ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಆಗತ್ತೈತೆ ಅದ, ಸೊ ಅದು ಬಂದ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ ನಾ. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ PDF. ಅಕ್ಷಯ್ ಅಡಳಿ, ಅಕ್ಷಯ್ अक्षय
यस सर
ये डाउट है तब
नो सर
नो डाउट ओके
नो नो
तो यस नेक्स्ट चलो वी मूव ऑन टू नेक्स्ट तो आई ओपन नेक्स्ट चलो सो दिस इज फॉर योर होमवर्क दिस इज फॉर योर होमवर्क सो इट इज गिवन हियर ओके A rectangular beam. So I'll share the image of this question. So you have to solve and you have to set it on my WhatsApp. Okay. So I'll read out the statement and I'll we'll discuss how to solve this problem. Okay. A rectangular concrete beam, 250 mm wide by 600 mm deep, is pre-stressed by means of 414 mm dia. High tensile bar located at 200 from surface of beam. If the effective stress in wire is 700 newton per mm square, what is the maximum bending moment that can be applied to the section without causing tension at the surface of the beam? Okay, so here the given data are they are given the width of beam as 250 mm. Then the depth of beam is 600 mm. Okay, and the pre-stressing is done by 414 mm dia wires. So the area of steel they are given 414 mm dia. Then they are given the eccentricity 200 mm. They are not given the eccentricity. They are given the location of cable. It is 200 mm. Okay. So here, if the effective stress in the wire is 700 newton per mm square, what is the bending moment it can resist? That we have to find out. Okay, section without causing tension at surface of the beam. Okay, so now we can see here. These are the given data already we have, or we have the answer also here. Okay, yes. Can you please note down and tell me how to solve this? Yes, anyone can calculate and check and tell me whether the pre-stressing force given here it is correct. Yes, if you have calculator now, please calculate and check. Balchandra, Bharti, yes, anyone? Ashwarya Hamdar.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you check the if your calculator the pre-stressing force whether it is 431 only? Can you see the pre-stressing force I have written here? It is 431. Can you check and tell me how to calculate pre-stressing force now? Anyone? Can anyone answer? Bharti.
Yes, sir.
How to calculate pre-stressing force now for this?
Sir, pre-stressing force is stress into area.
Stress is given how much?
Sir, 700 newton per mm square.
Yes, into area 4 into pi by 4 into d square. Diameter is 14, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you checked how much you got pre-stressing force? Others? Ashwarya Kurli?
Sir, 431.02.
Yes, very good, very good. Very good,
Ashwarya. 431, sir. 431.02. Yes.
And what about eccentricity? How much you got eccentricity? Please check. See, total depth is 600. And half of that it is 300. Center will be at 300. And the
100,
bars... 100, yes. Because the bars are located at a distance 200 mm. From soffit, so 300 minus 200, you get 100, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, how to get moment here? That is very important. How to get moment? Okay. So, from the stress distribution, so what you have to do now? क्या करना है आपको यहाँ पे which all term will come here? P by A plus P by Z or minus P by Z. So I'll show you. If you draw the stress distribution diagram, just a minute, I'll show you. Could not draw, so I'll share in the other pattern. Now we'll see how to solve this problem. Okay. So I'll share the screen here. Okay, now if you draw the stress distribution diagram, okay, we have like this, that is for P by A. Okay. Then this is for M by Z. It will be MD by Z or ML by Z. Then we get PE by Z. Correct? Is it correct? This is for M by Z, this is for P by Z. Okay, this is plus, we have plus, minus, correct? Sorry, this is, this should be minus, this should be minus, and this should be plus, correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what you have to, what they asked in the problem, maximum bending moment that can be applied to the section without causing tension at surface of the beam. So what you have to do now? So the final term P by A plus, what will happen? Plus P by Z. Or what you can do? Minus M by Z and plus P by Z equal to zero. Is it correct, Aishwarya, Huda?
Yes, sir.
And this, from this, what you have to calculate? We have to calculate what is M. You have to calculate M. Correct, now? See, what they ask, maximum bending moment that can be applied to the section without causing tension, at the surface of the beam, means at the surface, means this part you have to consider. Surface of the beam, okay. This part, as well as this part. So with respect to that, P by A minus M by Z plus P by Z. You have to add total together. So P by A, M by Z. So we have to find out M from this. We have already, what is P into E? You have P, we have E. So from this, you calculate M. And calculate and check whether you will get same answer. Is it clear how to get the answer? Or still have anyone doubts? Please ask if you have any doubts. Do you have any doubts? Yes, anyone having doubts? ಭಾರತಿ.
ಸರ್ ಇದು ಸಾಕನ್ ಸರ್, ಸರ್ ಇದು ಕಾಪಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಇದು ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದೇ ಸರಿಗೆ ಅದ್ರ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಅದು.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ನೋ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ ಬಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ
ಯಾ ಸರ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್.
ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೇರ್ ದ ಪಿ ಡಿ ಎಫ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಟು ರೀರೈಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಥ್ರೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೀ. ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್, ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್.
ಸರ್
ಹಾ ಹಾ ಆಸ್
ಸರ್ ಸರ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ಸರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಐ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸರ್.
ಹ್ಮ್
ಸರ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್.
ಓಕೆ ಐ ಐ ಐ ಶೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಟುಡೇ. ಓಕೆ ಟುಡೇ
ಯೆಸ್
ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಂಡ್ ಐ ಶೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೂಪ್. ಓಕೆ
ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.